request Dr. Perumal Swami to put a shawl to Dr. Paranam.
Okay, I take pressure to introduce the speaker. And Dr. Parandaman. Dr. Parandaman is a graduate from Kilpak Medical College and did his diploma in thoracic medicine from MMC. Later he did general medicine, MD general medicine from Stanley Medical College, completed in 1997. Then further to that, he has done a number of courses, which includes diploma in health sciences, the diabetology course, and he also has fellowship from Indian College of Physicians and fellowship from Royal College of Physicians, Glasgow. He has a tremendous number of awards and recognitions across from Nizam's Institute, from the Public Health Foundations, and he has received a number of certificates of merits, right, and has also been awarded as Best Doctor Award for Non-Communicable Disease by Royal Brunei Hospital. He is currently the professor of medicine at Kilpak Medical College, Government Hospital, Government Royal Brunei Hospital, Chennai. He comes with a rich experience. So over to Dr. Parandaman.
Thank you very much, sir, for kind words. Most respected chairpersons, senior faculties, vice president and secretary of IMA Kodambakkam branch, the most active branch in Chennai and Tamil Nadu, and dear friends. At the outset, I'd like to thank for my mentor, Professor S. Chandrasekhar, sir, having chosen me to receive this prestigious Oration Award, that is Dr. M. O. Venkatesan Oration Award. I am very much honored and humbled, sir. Thank you very much for the nice opportunity, sir. What I am going to talk in another thing, 20 minutes or so, how the alcohol affects how the other's liver and how the liver involvement leads to the complication and complicated disease and little mortality and mortality. It was found that we know the non-communicable diseases are increasing nowadays, like diabetes, hypertension, ischemic heart disease, coronary heart disease, I mean like dyslipidemia, malignancy, all are increasing. Similarly, the alcohol limit is also increasing, alcohol complications is also increasing, and death is also increasing. It was estimated that more than 2.5 million deaths occurs annually across the globe. And 90% of the people who takes daily and binge alcohol, they have a fatty liver. But among the 90%, only 10 to 15% develop alcoholic hepatitis. That is the precursor of cirrhosis. That is one of the most chronic complications of liver disease. If you take an alcohol, see, it goes to the stomach. The stomach is, you know, there is a conduit. It will mix only the food. The absorption will not occur in the stomach. Only few substances can absorb the stomach, like water, alcohol, and diabetic acid. These are three substances which are absorbed in the stomach. Otherwise, the rest of the food or whatever so is absorbed in the small intestine. If you take an alcohol which is absorbed in the stomach and it's metabolized by alcohol dehydrogenase, which is present in the stomach, and also it's metabolized by the microsomal. The ethanol activating system, oxidizing system, which is present in the stomach, which converts alcohol into acetaldehyde. Actually, alcohol is not toxic. Alcohol does not harm, but only the aldehyde will harm. So, immediately what happens, the aldehyde is converted to acetate. Acetate is used as a substrate for the TCA cycle or the things. So, alcohol will not, acetaldehyde will not, that is, aldehyde will not stay in the system, immediately metabolized to acetate. And what the acetate does, all the way, it quenches the glutathione, which is present in the liver, which is an antioxidant. So aldehyde, it metabolizes or damages or destroys the glutathione, which is antioxidant in the liver, thereby causing injury. During the conversion of alcohol to acetaldehyde, a lot of energy is produced, like NADPH is converted to NADP, more hydrogens are produced, that is called free radicals. These free radicals cause oxidative damage and heat that again cause the damage to the liver. Similarly, the glutathione is an antioxidant which is quenched by the acetaldehyde that increases the free radical damage to the system. Because if you continue to take alcohol, the most of the acetate which is converted to most of acetaldehyde converted to acetate by acetaldehyde dehydrogenase, or dehydrogenase, that is depleted. If it is depleted, the acetate is not formed. What is the increased levels of acetaldehyde that leads to injury? If it is immediately converted to acetate, the acetate will not be there, so it will not cause injury. So if you continue to take alcohol for longer duration, this down regulation of this rest of the enzyme that leads to increased level of acetate. As a result, increased numbers of aldehyde goes that binds to the protein, that's a lipoprotein and amino acids and sulfide group. These are the membrane proteins. It goes this acetaldehyde with the membrane protein, the form molecule called attack molecule. So the acetaldehyde with the membrane protein in the several sites from attack molecule and changes the cell structure of the liver cell. So it becomes antigenic cell. So normal liver cell is not antigenic. Which antibody is not produced against liver cell. Because this aldehyde goes attached to this protein and makes a molecule, different molecule, it's called new antigen. This new antigen is inviting the antibody production by creating the immune system. So immune system is triggered and more antibody is produced against our own hepatocytes. So now the situation where you are there, where the antibodies are produced against the liver cell in our system, that is triggered by acetaldehyde. So if you continue to take alcohol, there is damage to the mucosa, the gastric mucosa and intestinal mucosa, and increased permeability of the bacteria for the gut. The gut bacteria, the endotoxemia occurs, it goes to the activates the Cooper's in the liver, there is increased fibrogenesis in the liver and modifies and damages, and the genetic polymorphism occurs both male and female and causing more and more injury. So, what is so-called alcohol dehydrogenase, which is more in female? That is the reason even small quantity, if the female takes, they develop more injury than the male, age-based male, because of increased amount of that enzyme, that's called alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme in the stomach. If that is less, if however you take alcohol, you will not produce toxicity. So, that is more dangerous in females, the increased levels of acetaldehyde. As a result of these immune system mediated effects on the liver, it produces fatty liver. The fatty liver usually, if any person who takes alcohol less than 80 grams per day, or 40 to 80 grams for 5 to 10 years, they produce fatty liver. So why this is fatty, this condition is important? If anyone recognizes at this point of time, if you restrict or you abstain from alcohol intake, you can completely reverse to normal. This is the most important stage where we can do justice for our patient. If you continue to take alcohol, not only the duration, a large amount, that is around 180 grams. I tell you what's a gram. 1 gram, that is if you want to assess, we know only ml. So 1 quarter, that is 180 ml. 1 cutting, 90 ml. 1 peg is 60 ml. 1 ounce, 30 ml. We know that one, but we don't know the grams. So for that, we have the calculation, not that question, only formed one. If you take one beer, 330 ml of beer, that contains 12 grams of alcohol. If you take 4 ounces of wine, that is 120 ml of wine, you have 12 grams of alcohol. you drink 25 ml of rectified spirit, it has got 12 grams of alcohol. So 12 grams of alcohol in this condom. So you have to calculate that way. So how much he takes and you calculate the gram so that that particular gram is important. If you take more than 160 gram per day for more than 10 to 20 years, you develop hepatitis. Again, this stage is important. If you recognize at this point of time, if you stop taking alcohol, you abstain from taking alcohol, probably it may recover and you can prevent the damage, chronic complication of liver disease. Again, if he doesn't obey, continue to take alcohol, then there is a zone 3 fibrosis. So why is the zone 3 fibrosis? Because the alcohol decadence is not only in the stomach, it is also present in zone 3 in the liver. So more and more alcohol producing in the liver at zone 3, so it's called zone 3 fibrosis. Leads to, that is cirrhosis liver. If a patient suffers with hepatitis C and B in addition to alcohol ingestion, the rapid progression, instead of 10 years, he develops the complication 5 years. In addition to the liver problem, he may also have pancreatitis, the pancreatic calcific pancreatitis, pancreatitis, and biliary stricture is developed, and it is the most dreadful complication, like worse than the cirrhosis liver. And finally, he got to hepatocellular carcinoma. And also it increases the enzyme in this and all the enzymes that increase the toxicity of the drugs what you use in otherwise also. So if you do the laboratory, the basic investigation, what you do, clinical examination, you can find out the liver, but if you do ultrasound, you will find out fatty liver, you do fibrosis scan, all the C's are available. So you do the fatty liver or the ultrasound. Regarding the enzymes, AST, ALT, and gamma glutamate transpeptides, not glutamate transferase, now we say gamma glutamate transpeptides and triglycerides. If anything, so most of the time in alcohol age, there is elevation of transpeptides, glutamate transpeptides, and triglycerides elevated. If you compare the AST ALT ratio, AST will be elevated more than ALT, that is, the ratio is more than 2:1. Normally, in liver disease, ALT will be elevated, but in alcohol liver disease, AST will be elevated. Because both affects both the microsomal enzyme and the cytosolic enzyme, and all over the cell, so it leads to increase the AST elevation. And also, if you look into the liver, there is proteins. If proteins are decreased, alcohol is decreased, that means a chronic liver disease you are dealing with. In addition to acute hepatitis, and acute hepatitis evidence by increase of prothrombin type. Ultrasound will tell you, and then you have to look for the portal flow reversal in ultrasonography in addition to the fatty liver, and also you can do fibro scan to find out it is a cirrhosis liver. So management's general principle is stop taking alcohol, stop alcohol intake. Abstain. If you obtain the fatty liver, complete reversibility. If you take the hepatitis, partial reversibility. If you have to stop your chronic cirrhosis liver, you cannot prevent the reverse the pathology, but still you can prevent the complication of death. So at any point of time, stop with alcohol is important. And in addition, you treat the patient with alcohol with blood withdrawal state, thymine, and the paclitaxel combination of that is the IV infusion containing glucose and multivitamins, because he does not take food properly. The glucose, that is the alcohol juice, is empty calories. Empty calories means the calories what is produced is utilized, but it's not stored. So he can live with calories, but it cannot be stored. That's empty calories. So he doesn't take food properly, and it prevents absorption of food also if you take excess. As a result, the nutritional deficiency develops. So that's the one thing which causes. And treatment of malnutrition, vitamin K deficiency, especially in acute hepatitis, where it increases prothrombin time, you have to treat hepatic decomposition as required. In that regard, we have got a few drugs to give. There are some evidences. There are some evidence to support few drugs. There are no evidence to support some drugs, and there are some partial evidences there. So the evidence to support this type of steroid is, one is a corticosteroid. You know why corticosteroid is in people? Because this is an alcohol disease, why is it corticosteroid? It is not an immune mediated disease. But because that's the reason why you put the pathophysiology, it triggers the immune system. All the damage caused by alcohol is due to hepatitis, due to immunity activation. So what is required is immunosuppression. And by the immune trigger is a steroid. So anti-inflammatory. So steroid is the most important drug. It can be given for the period of 28 days, then 40 mg per day for 28 days. If you see the improvement within 7 days of initiation of treatment, the patient improves, you can continue treatment. If it's not improving, you can stop the steroid because it's a double-edged weapon. And second drug is a pentoxifilin. Pentoxifilin is a phosphatase inhibitor. It modulates the production of TNF alpha, That's one of the inflammatory cytokines that's involved in the pathogenesis of the liver. So you can modulate that, decrease the amount and decrease the viscosity of blood. So perfusion increases. That's all useful for hepatitis. Third thing is some nutritional support, as already alluded to. Then there are some drugs which have insufficient evidence, like anabolic steroids, infliximab, etanercept. These are TNF alpha antibodies and monoclonal antibodies. This can be used, but there is no evidence as of now. But it is found to be useful. No evidence for the propylthiamine uracil, insulin glucose, colchicine, antioxidants. They are proposed. They study the studies does not support these drugs. So methoxyfolate, as I alluded to, that is a phosphatase inhibitor. If the transcription, that is the TNF alpha gene transcription, is altered, so decrease production of TNF alpha. That's the one thing is very important. And regarding corticosteroid, there are a lot of studies, randomized control studies supports the use of corticosteroid. And before that, before you use a corticosteroid, you have to calculate your discriminant function. Discriminant function is 4.6 into difference in prothrombin time plus serum bilirubin. If it is more than 32, that is indication for serum, and also you can indicate for pentoxifying. Or you can do any scoring system. There is end-stage disease, model for end-stage disease, or gaps of acute hepatic failure system disease. Any scoring system can be used. More than this, hepatitis steroid indicator. The prognosis, if you see the prognosis, if prothrombin is more than 5 seconds, the difference is more than 5 seconds, the prognosis is poor. That is acute liver failure, acute liver disease. And if the serum bilirubin is more than 8, again, prognosis is poor. Renal failure, ascites, disinfection more than 8, so these are the things, poor prognostic index. So you have to tell the patient at the time of admission that prognosis is poor. Apart from that, any number of times you advise the patient, you have appreciated, you have noted that he is not listening to our advice because the craving for taking all the addictions or habituation. So that is treated by acamprosate calcium. Is a drug used to decrease the craving for alcohol. That's a new drug. So other drugs like the drug which is not supported, but anyway there are few drugs available in the market. Silymaril is extract of milk desiccated seed. It supplies flavonoids. Flavonoids is an antioxidant. So silymaril, they are studied. They are found to be useful for fatty liver because it's a flavonoid. It's like it's just vitamin. And essentially, it's a phospholipid. What is the function? It improves the detoxification function of the liver. So liver has got synthetic function, detoxification, metabolic function, so many functions are there. The essential improves the detoxification function. Hence, it can be used. But there are no randomized control studies to prove this is effective. And vinorelaxin is a drug which clears the alcohol from the blood. Because it comes to alcohol intoxication, definitely alcohol concentration more the concentration, more the damage. So the drug which is useful is metoxyl that clears alcohol from the blood. It found to be useful. Again, we need to have a large and randomized studies to prove this effect of it. Levopil is the multivitamin, the combination multivitamin, which is necessary. What is deficient in alcoholics? Especially folic acid, pyridoxine, thiamine, silymaril, metoxyl, all these are combined in one pill. So this is definitely useful and it's not a supporting care. It is not a standard drug to be recommended, but it's a supporting care for the liver. Whatever the liver does, the liver synthesizes, it is not able to now produce because of the liver failure, and we are supplementing by the exogenous. And drugs like L52, tefloidine, all these things are some plant extract, is ayurvedic medicine. Or no proven benefit, but it may have some effect, but no proven studies to show this are beneficial. So based on this, because of occurrence of so much of alcohol admissions, and since I've been in intensive care for so many years, I thought I'd do a study on alcohol intoxication, acute alcohol complication in intensive care government-run hospital. So I conducted a study. It's only observation, it's a simple study. I conducted a study on this. In that, all got admitted with acute complications like seizure, hepatic encephalopathy, or UJ bleed, all related acute, alcoholic related complications are admitted in the hospital over a period of 8 months. 8 months from July 2016 to February 2017. 8 months, just observation study. Number of cases total 52, out of 52, 2 females. Because surprisingly, 2 female acute alcohol related complications. Very, very alarming. acute organ complication, two females. And 50 males and two females. Each for them cases was taken, was studied, the profile of the same, what are the age, where are they coming from, what amount of alcohol taking, what is the brand they are taking, what is the duration they are making, history was taken. And we have excluded the patient associated problems like diabetes, hypertension, dyslipidemia, protein heart disease, all the other comorbidities are deleted. Only pure alcoholic liver disease, the acute combination are taken for the study. In that, the criteria we apply, what is the decomposition criteria? They should have this criteria by definition. Aside is being ready by parting the variation by endoscopy, all this are confirmed by our investigations. And ultrasound was done again to see the portal flow direction and the fatty liver, all these things. And if you liver function, all the tests, the basic tests we have done, liver function test, complete blood count, renal function, all the profile we have done. What the observation made? Observation made was, there are out of 52 patients, 33 cases, that is 63% belongs to 59 to 60 years. It constitutes 50 to 60 years. It contributed about 63%. So we are not interested in this group because 50 to 60 years is really old. What you are interested in is, what is this? See, 20 to 40 years. 17 cases of acute alcoholic complication in intensive care, IMCU. Some are married, some are not married, some are married having small kid, a young lady, house with wife. See, that was most recent for us. 17 patients, acute complication in this age group. And of course, more than 60 was only 2 cases. And the distribution of complications, these subsets were analyzed. It was symptomatic DCLD with a minor complication, majority 31%. So symptomatic DCLD, no problem. The minor complication with some vague symptom, tiredness, all this. UJ bleed, 7 cases, that is 13% UJ bleed. UJ bleed is a fatal complication. 7 cases. Hepatic encephalopathy, 7 cases. Every sample is 7 cases out of 52. And seizure 6 cases, hypoglycemia 2 cases. So these are description of cases, and this also we are interested in because the complications are fatal complications. So same thing are depicted in the bar chart. And also we have found, analyzed, what is the duration of organ they come taken, because the acute complications are good, whether they are taken for lesser duration or longer duration, or whatever the duration we have analyzed. So we have taken the duration of organ intake, less than 5 years, 5 to 10 years, 10 to 20 years, more than 20 years. Of that, the 1 person, less than 5 years, no complication. If at all complication, only one complication, that was aortic encephalopathy. Less than 5 years, no complications, except one, aortic encephalopathy. More than 5 to 20 years, almost all complications. Right from DCLD, with symptomatic, asymptomatic, ED bleed, encephalopathy, seizures, and all the other 5 to 10 years. More than 20 years, they are safe. They know the technique of taking. They are used to take. They are happy to take. They know how to live. So if anyone takes more than 20 years, they are safer people. So that's also, that constitutes few complications, not very much. Then, apart from that, you analyze the quantity of alga. Maybe duration is okay. What is the quantity? Sometimes they take 1 year only, but take large 5 quarters. I've seen one photo, he said 12 quarters per day. I could not believe it. 12 quarters, sir, I'm taking 12, I've seen 12 quarters. How can you really? No, I've been taking like this last one month because I fought with my wife. Wife left me. Because so many other reasons. Because we're knowing all the reasons. So, he started taking, instead of taking 4 quarters, 5 quarters a day, he started taking 12 quarters. He will also live and he will not have the complication. So we analyze the quantity, less than 180 ml, that is 1 quarter. Less than 180 ml, 360 ml, more than 360 ml. We found that less than 180 ml, that is less, 1 quarter, no problem. DCLD, that is decomposition disease, with the minimal symptom, minor symptoms. So it is okay, not bad. It comes with wake up, abdominal distension, tiredness, fatigue, some not BP was low. So we have transfused fluids and become alright. So minor complications. So this more than 360 ml. Most of them present with UJP without DCL. So if you take large quantity of alcohol, they present with UJP, erosive gastritis, they come with a fatal bleed. But fortunately, those who take large quantity of alcohol comes with a major bleed, they are revived easily by supportive measures, blood transfusion, salt support. At the same time, if you have a chronic liver disease patient, comes with a major bleed, it's very difficult to survive. That's what we observed our study. So, based on this, we analyze the data. The shorter the duration, larger quality, usually bleed due to erosive gastritis. No DCL, no decompensation, only erosive gastritis. So that can be easily managed. And early is out of it, because less than 5 years, one fellow came with the early is out of it. 5 years, 25-year-old boy came with the early is out of it. That is again revived. So no problem. Longer duration, mild to moderate quantity, then have all sorts of things. DCL to minor complication, DCL to hepatitis only, erosive gastritis, all these things. So, larger, moderate to larger quantity, you have all complications, what you already mentioned. Small quantity with longer duration, that's what more than 60 years we found. More than 60 years, small quantity, longer duration, they live long. They decompensate with the hepatic encephalopathy, hypoglycemia, that's what the symptoms you have. They're symptomatic, DCL with the minor complications are more further. So, they live symptomatic, DCL with the minor complication, majority. And they also come across, they came across DCL with the hepatic encephalopathy and hypoglycemia. So, we compared the other studies, what they have done in other states. The female were, in our setup, only 2 patients female. But the studies done in Uganda, 50-50, 50 male, 50 female. But here, only 2 out of 52. That is, because of social stigma, people are not taking. Now, because it is urbanization, people are taking, started taking. So maybe, in near future, we'll be getting more. And also analyze binge drink. Binge drinking was more in BMAs in our study. It's also similar to other studies also done at Delker and Delker et al. They also showed that the binge drinking was more in males. Yes, the patient started consuming alcohol at younger age. Some people, they developed started taking alcohol at younger age. They have a fulminant form of UJP and DCL. So, in energy, if it takes, they develop UJP without. Decompensated disease. Already, this was mentioned. It's large quantity. So, the early symptomatology and seizure disorders, they are not associated with DCL. The two complications, neurologic complication, early symptomatology and seizure disorder, if they were not associated with the decompensated disease, the patient did not have any deranged liver for parameters. Only directly they presented with the CNS manifestation because of the large quantity in the younger individual. And then, this is the most important thing already alluded to. We have observed more the duration of alcohol consumption. Also, the usual bleeding, second to DCL. So, if we have longer duration of alcohol intake, they'll have DCLD with the usual bleeding. But the shorter duration of alcohol intake, usually bleeds with the erosive gastritis. This is the most important point, second point we observed. And what you observe, again, another observation is this. When we study, we go to the medical ward, the gastroenterology ward, present with the ascites, massive ascites, we do tap, house ages we do tap, usually at the age of 50, 60, mostly above 50. Now found that at the age of 25, severe cirrhosis liver disease with massive ascites, the hepatic reservoir is 25 years. The last they say, when you start taking alcohol, it's taking alcohol, they are 15. And what is 2 to 3 quarters a day? They started with a small 1 peg, 2 peg, they step up till you get the full effect, 3 to 4 quarters a day. And then with this, the transition occurrence of alcohol and decompensation from middle age to old age to the younger age, that was observation in our study. And also, the patient who started consuming alcohol at younger age, they develop on UJP without DCL. Those who take alcohol at younger age, they develop UJP without reason. And in our study, there are 4 deaths occurred, that is 50 out of 52, only 4 deaths occurred. 2 are the massive bleed usually with the DCLD. So the DCLD usually with the DCLD is difficult to manage because this associated coagulopathy and chronic complication, port hypertension. The port hypertension is severe. Whatever the measures you take, port hypertension cannot reverse and difficult and patient related to complication. Even erosic acidities, you PPIs, infusion, all these things, supporting pressure, blood, you can save the patient. And 2 rate of hepatic encephalopathy, again, they came in a very more advanced state. At that point of time, we could not save the 2 hepatic encephalopathy. And the other encephalopathies were revived. Out of 7, 5 were revived. What are take-home messages? So take-home message is this. If you identify a fatty liver, and if you completely abstain from taking alcohol, completely reversible. So still we can do justice. Still we do good thing for the patient. If you identify the hepatitis level, still it's possible, still reversible. It might not be completely reversible, but we can reverse a complication of cirrhosis and cirrhosis related complication. If identified cirrhosis liver, it is irreversible for the liver injury, but you can prevent the complication of hepatic failure and encephalopathy and other complications if you again stop on. Again, the treatment is stopping on. If you continue to take alcohol, in spite of our advice, all these things, die early with acute complications. UJ bleed, hepatic encephalopathy, all these things. Hence, what is required? Adequate education about the hazardous effects of alcohol consumption, legislation, and early diagnosis treatment will decrease the morbidity and mortality of due to alcohol in future. Thank you very much for patience. I wish you all a happy new year to the
system. Thank you very much, Dr. Pranam, for your terrific lecture. Now I request to Dr. Peruma, pass this may hand over the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Pranam.